This is TWiT.
And now it's time to talk about this article heralding the death of Wintel.
Yep.
And really what John
Mark Luigi, Twain said.
Yes. Great league.
Everyone has an opinion. Yeah. Yours is wrong.
Yeah.
No.
This is predicated on the introduction of Apple Silicon and a move by Apple away from Intel towards its own custom chips.
Yeah, and by the way, for those who are not familiar, Jean-Louis Gasset, former Apple executive, I think he took over the Mac group after Steve Jobs left the company.
I think VP of Europe and became Apple. I can't remember what his final title was, but yeah, he was there in the post Jobs, in the Jobs interregnum. Yep.
And he founded B Inc., the computer company that could have become the basis for the next Mac OS, but they bought Next instead and brought Steve Jobs back. As long ago as then, so this would have been the mid to late 90s, this guy used to blog all the time. He would do this on B's website at the time, later on other places. I don't remember the exact history of it, but I've always been fascinated by him. I agree with his opinions a lot. He's obviously an industry insider. I like him. I've always liked him.
I think he's great. He's smart. He's fun.
I think he's terrible.
Oh! Get the gong for Mary Jo!
What's up?
I never read him because I'm always wondering, why do people who understand Microsoft care what a former Apple person
thinks? Well, that's
a
good point. He did work at HP for a while.
Oh, I see.
He's not.
This is a guy who has developed operating systems, right? I mean, this is... I don't think of him as he's not a Microsoft expert or anything. I mean, he's just a industry guy.
He's got a unique perspective. I agree. He's not necessarily, he's often been wrong.
Yeah. Okay. But I mean, I don't think of it in those terms. I mean, I think I told you guys the story. Mary Jo was there, but it was probably at, I almost said Tech Ed, Ignite last year or maybe the year before, something like that. Mary Jo and I had finished our thing up on the stage and had come down and some people were there and we were talking to him. And this guy said something to me sort of offhanded, like, well, you said that Google would never buy YouTube. And I was like, what? And he says, you said that Google would never buy YouTube. And I'm like, I didn't know idea what he was talking about. So I went and looked it up. And yeah, and sure enough, on Windows Weekly 2000 years ago, there was a rumor that Google was going to buy YouTube. And I was like, I don't see that happening. And here's why. And I kind of spell it why I didn't think it was going to happen. Obviously, Google bought YouTube. People harbor these grudges. I got that wrong, and he's never forgotten it. And you were wrong about this, or you were wrong about this. Like, whatever. To me, this is like decades of conversations. And I like this guy. I enjoy his blogs and whatever. And so he had written one last week called The Passing of Wintel, without a question mark. And I set it aside. I subscribe to Medium. That's where he posts now. And so I bookmarked it. And I'm like, I want to spend some time and really look at this. And I kind of read through it. And I was like, not exactly. And I the part I took exception to, and again, I'm not doing this to blast this guy. Like I said, I still find his opinion very interesting. I don't mean like, this guy said that, I don't mean it like that. I think people he falls into this kind of lose sight of some of the big picture stuff. The reason that it makes sense for Apple to adopt its own chipset for the Mac is that, well, there's a bunch of reasons, but two of them are they can improve the products in tandem, right? So they can make the chips work better for the software and vice versa, which is cool. Absolutely. Oh, yep. No, I mean, right. It is real. And the other very real thing is, well, it's cheaper for them to do this. I mean, they already own the chips. Like it's cheaper for them to use their own stuff. It's actually, and whether they pass those savings along to customers is one thing that people are debating. Some people believe some next generation Macs will be less expensive in part because of this. Some people think Apple would never do that and they'll keep their margins high.
We talked about that yesterday, and I think the consensus was, Apple actually doesn't look at whether it's cheaper or not. What they look at is what's going to be the first premise, which is what's going to be the better product. Because they know that that's a virtuous cycle. That if they make a better product, more people will buy it. They will make more money. They're not
really, they don't care about cutting prices.
They don't look at the iPhone. Price doesn't drive them, I guess. What drives them is making the best.
The first.
Well, there are limits. They can't go too high. admittedly. But they're not trying to get low. They're trying to make the best possible product.
Okay. Well, so I would just say both of those ideas have some merit. I don't have an opinion.
Definitely going to save money. I mean, there's no question.
Okay. Right? There you go.
Yeah.
So his premise, part of his premise, because actually he made four or five different points about this and why this was so inevitable that ARM would take over the world and blah, 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 whatever, is that like that kind of pricing model actually works against ARM in the PC space because we already have a company, Intel, that makes a range of chips for the PC market, and it really hasn't had much competition for a lot of its lifetime. And so it has done this on its own. Like ARM can't come into what is for it a boutique market and lower prices. In fact, the opposite has occurred. If you look at the prices of ARM-based PCs, they're incredibly expensive. There's the Lenovo Flex 5G that I'm testing right now starts at, I think, $1,299. The version with an Intel chip in it, and it's a core 10th generation quad-core core processor. It's not like a low-end thing. Is, I think, $509. Mm-hmm. So it's, you know, that Apple could save money by using its own chips in its own volume platform absolutely makes sense. That some version of ARM could come to the Windows PC space and trigger a price reduction is ludicrous. In fact, one of the biggest problems we've had in the PC market over the years, and Microsoft came out with Surface in part to correct this, was that PC makers had lowered the prices so much that PCs became kind of devalued. They became less, you know, less good as products. They became netbooks. You know, they were racing to the bottom. Today, the sweet spot in the PC space is in the high hundreds. You know, the sweet spot in the Mac space is in the mid 1500s or something like that. I mean, they exist at different levels, and there are things about ARM that are good for the PC that may influence Intel and AMD to do better. You know, the longevity stuff, the always on connectivity, and so forth. But like pricing, that has absolutely not happened. It's already happened.
There was that story today in a Reuters story saying ARM is raising their prices on chip technology. Right, so yeah. It starts out not low. And it's going to get higher.
Yeah, I think the reality is that the PC market is this kind. It's a legacy product. We are really stuck on the Windows side with a compatibility problem that we can't get past. I mean, Microsoft refuses to leave behind any legacy software, any legacy technologies, because its business customers rely on stuff from the 1980s or 90s or whatever it is. They just can't do it, and that is a problem ARM does not solve. Mm-hmm. You know, and so Apple, by being more aggressive all along, has been able to move the Mac forward in ways that we just don't do on the PC side. And it moving to ARM can work. There's no doubt about it. Mm-hmm. It's not clear that Windows moving to ARM will ever work. And my experience, like I think we talked about this last week, my experience with a modern ARM-based PC has been very disappointing. Whereas I think the Mac is going to be, I think it's going to succeed wildly. I think it's going to be great.
Mm-hmm. Right. The whole premise of his argument was what Apple's doing is going to force Microsoft to do something with Windows 10 on ARM. I disagree completely. I don't think it's going to force Microsoft to do that. I don't.